There's no denying the fact here that one of the most established characters out there by John and Dave is, of course, Din Djarin and Grogu. All right, these two characters really are like the bond of the Mandalorian series. We know that they are meant to be together. That's the overall structure of those two character arcs and exactly how it kind of really caters to the whole idea of family in Star Wars, as we saw at the end of Mando Season 3, where Din says he will be adopting him, and how he becomes Din Grogu. This is Mike Zero. Subscribe if you're new and like this video to see future Star Wars updates. I'm also on Twitter at MikeZero1. I thank you also very much for the great and kind support. And let's get right into this. Now, we know that there's been a very big situation happening for the past couple of weeks now between Pedro and Kathleen Kennedy and the whole firing situation related to Pedro Pascal over the Skeleton Crew series specifically. Let's just be very clear about that. And there's more to the story that we will be elaborating on right now and how it kind of makes things quite worse, not just for Kathleen Kennedy and what she did, but also for what Pedro Pascal had to go through and what led to his ultimate demise from getting removed from the Skeleton Crew series. So let's just tap right into exactly what really happened and what led to this point as well. Now, we know that Kathleen Kennedy always makes very bad decisions. This is nothing new, nothing surprising among the fandom. However, currently Disney is beginning to rethink their strategy when it involves the balance of the ratio, so to speak, between Star Wars movies and Star Wars shows. However, the recent firing of Pedro Pascal from the Skeleton Crew series and that whole situation just got worse, as it recently led Kathleen Kennedy to recasting Din Djarin with a new actor. As it turns out, another reason why Pedro Pascal was fired by Kennedy from Skeleton Crew as Din Djarin had a lot to do with the fact that not only did Kennedy have a plan to shoot a scene where Din seemingly dies, but she also wanted to completely change his design with new armor that would make the character unrecognizable to the audience, since the series is or was planned to take place years after The Mandalorian Season 3. And about that ultimate demise of the character, Kathleen Kennedy wanted to make it that Din would seemingly be killed off, leaving it like an ambiguous thing, where fans had to guess, is he dead, is he alive, something like that. That's basically what Kathleen Kennedy is planning to do with Skeleton Crew, and initially before that, she wanted to actually kill the character off, but Disney executives stepped in, Bob Iger stepped in and prevented that from happening, and downgraded it to making it more of an ambiguous thing. Moving on. Now, Pedro Pascal was in full disagreement with this approach of his design change, as he completely disagreed and dreaded the new design for Din Djarin, which was going to appear much more like Boba Fett's armor, with a darker tone and different designs to the helmet. Pedro felt that this made zero sense by Kennedy, and it caused a lot of creative differences between himself and those associated with Skeleton Crew like John Watts. The design change was reportedly so severe and different to the point where Pedro was extremely worried about fan backlash over the design changes. So here's the deal about this. You can't really change the character's armor all that much. I get the overall structure of Din Djarin upgrading his armor is modeled after a video game. Yes, guys, that's true. Jon Favreau talked about this, that Din Djarin, you know, upgrading his armor series by series on a show by show basis is modeled after the role playing video games out there, where you can upgrade your armor, kind of upgrade your appearance, stuff like that. John got the idea from that. And you know what? Hey, I mean, that's a real cool visionary thing or style, and I like that. But for Kathleen Kennedy to completely just change the character's design to the point where it's unrecognizable is just uncalled for, and obviously seems like a control mechanism by Kathleen Kennedy. It seems like she has some kind of obsessive thing when it comes to controlling certain designs of characters, right? Moving on again, all right, now these design changes, all right, were reportedly so severe and different to the point that Pedro was actually very concerned about the fan backlash. These creative struggles and disagreements between Pedro and Kathy also are what led to Pedro's removal from Skeleton Crew and not getting involved with his cameos as Din Djarin in the show to face both the pirates and the Necromancer Stormtroopers. You guys may be wondering to yourselves, what in the world are Necromancer Stormtroopers? These are actually troopers that are going to be powered by Sith alchemy, by Thrawn's army in the Ahsoka series. They're going to be introduced in there, and they are going to be pretty much, you know, reestablished in the Skeleton Crew show. So just be aware about that as well. These troopers are going to have, like, these golden cracks over their armor, kind of like Kylo Ren's mask in The Rise of Skywalker, except the entirety of their armor is going to be covered like that, except in gold. And given that the characters are powered by Sith alchemy, I think it's pretty safe to say that this is somewhat similar to the Blackwing virus in the Star Wars franchise, where it's basically an undead army. A lot of fans may like this or hate this, it really depends, but, you know, moving on to the next big thing here is that this was described to be the final factor in Pedro's removal and disagreeing with both Kathy and John Watts and their direction for Din Djarin, as they also wanted to add in some comedic value for the character with Grogu as well and Skeleton Crew, something that Pedro viewed as off-putting to the core characteristics of Din. As of now, Kennedy already has multiple actors in mind to take Pedro's place both as the voice and acting as Din in this series only. So, again, Kathleen Kennedy making one of the worst decisions possible in Skeleton Crew that is only making things worse for not just the character of Din, but also for the whole Pedro Pascal firing situation. And again, you know, we got to be very clear, time and time again, Pedro is not fired in the general sense, but only from the Skeleton Crew series. And so he's still coming back from Mando Season 4, Ahsoka Season 2, and there's been quite a number of hints that he will make even a big cameo in the Ahsoka series. So, a lot of things coming out of, you know, this whole Skeleton Crew situation, and I think it's a lot of the reason why we have yet to have gotten a full release date or a release date window, you know, for the Skeleton Crew show. We don't even know when it's arriving. It's supposed to come out this year in 2023, but we still don't know which month Skeleton Crew is coming out. Now, given that Ahsoka is coming out in August, it's very easy to say that Skeleton Crew will be dropping by, I would say, November to December, most certainly. And that's if they even make that time frame, right? Because we know that they're still doing some minor reshoots right now, especially for the Din Djarin scenes, and who knows if that's even going to make it to the final cut, because Disney executives, as of now, they do not want Din Djarin involved, because Pedro's not involved, they feel it's not right, it's not good ethics, and you know what? Disney's right. You know, I think that these are really poor ethics by Kathleen Kennedy, you know, doing all these different things to the character. And Pedro, I believe, had, you know, the full right to really kind of speak up for himself and really raise his concerns. So overall, I would like to hear what you guys have to say about this below in the comments. And if you guys did enjoy the content for today, make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. And I will catch you guys next time. Night to moon.